I've got lawyer Matt Rooney on the line right now. Matt, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. I appreciate your insight on this. So you heard Senator Ray Lesniak talking about how this is a horrible deal. It's a billion-dollar gift to ExxonMobil. What do you say?
Yeah, I mean, right now I'm a lot more concerned about cleaning up what Senator Lesniak just spewed on the airwaves here, Bill. He is wrong on so many different levels we don't even have enough time. To start with?
Tell me.
He's continuing to lie about this $225 million figure. We have administrative orders going back to the 90s, which already address remediation. This $225 million, that's on top of it. So when he throws his $8.9 billion figure out there, that's what the plaintiffs here were asking for. I'm an attorney, Bill. If I got everything I asked for in court, we wouldn't be having this conversation because I'd be on a private island somewhere far and safe away from Ray Lesniak and a bunch of his Trenton buddies. But I'm not, because you don't always get what you ask for. When you settle, you naturally end up somewhere in between. And as you correctly stated, for example, if you go back between 2002-2006, New Jersey settled about 267 of these when folks like Ray Lesniak were in charge. Guess what the grand total was, Bill?
Tell me.
$29.4 million. So Chris Christie, believe it or not, even though his critics will never give him credit for it, could be considered New Jersey's greatest environmentalist in terms of raw tax dollars for settlements.
How about that? That's a, you know, that's an interesting take. If I remember, the Sierra Club actually endorsed him when he ran the first time.
Yeah, they absolutely
right?
did. So there's only one variable that's changed here, Bill. He's a Republican running for president. And whether you're voting for Chris Christie or you abhor the idea, it's clear what's going on.
So, Matt, explain to me, though, what I'm confused about, you know, and Ray pointed this out, that this goes back to 1907. And I'm thinking that when the judge said they got to stop operations before we clean it up, who wants to see them stop operations? I think that you keep using this. It's not like this is impacting anyone's drinking water. It's very deceiving to talk about groundwater contamination because it is unrelated to drinking water.
Well, that's correctly right. And the thing that I think your listeners need to remember here, this is not a Republican-Democrat issue. Most reasonable people can agree that we want to have a clean environment and a safe drinking water supply, for instance. But not only does this settlement not correlate to that, but people like Ray Lesniak, they would have us driving Flintstone cars if they could have their way.
Oh, with the feet on the ground?
That's exactly right. Yabba dabba do. Okay? So this is not at all about actually remediating anything Exxon did. This is about publishing a guy who's from a different political party than he is. And this is also about a radical ideology that does not correlate to fact. If you're really interested in making sure that New Jerseyans are paid for whatever this company allegedly did, again, Chris Christie just got you a record settlement. So I'd really love to hear Ray Lesniak explain why that's a problem when people from his own party, from his own ideology, just 6 years ago, 7 years ago, were saying a settlement like this size would be fantastic, would be a wonderful result for the taxpayers in New Jersey.
Okay, Matt Rooney, you heard now you've heard the other side. Matt Rooney, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Always good to talk to you. Keep up the good work with the Save Jersey blog, and we'll be talking to you soon, I'm sure.